name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The waters of baptism. Linda died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him.
Punished, yet it is their hope. full of immortality. Chastise the little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated. She was only given 68 years. Linda Moore lived a very full life, made the most of it, and leaves lots of people behind that love her very much. What a wonderful turnout this funeral yesterday. And this morning, and our hearts go out in a very, very special way to Linda's family. Husband Dave married 45 years. And that's a real testimony, Dave. And she's watching over you now like she never did before, knowing exactly what to pray for, knowing exactly now how to help. And that influence, that prayer continues. And her children and spouses, Brad and Leslie, Susie and Matthew, Brother Dennis, wife Christy, Sister Diane, and all other relatives and friends that we remember today, living and deceased. And we come together this morning to this church to take to heart the words that heard in the first reading today, the Old Testament, the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God. And we believe this. We trust Him. You all know Linda in many ways. Some ways in common, other ways very personal. Conversation that you had, experience that you had, memories that you made, in all kinds of ways. And we bring those this morning. She was born on the 25th of June, 1953, and a resident of our South Amherst community. Graduated from South Amherst High School in 1971. Served as administrative assistant for 25 years in education. Active in softball as a parent and as a coach. And Callie Baker had these lines. Linda was an example of what a fearless, kind-hearted, compassionate woman could do, all the while having laughter that made everyone around her feel happy. She was humble to a fault, never wanting recognition for all that she did within the sport and the community that I love so much. I hope that she understands the impact she had on so many of us here in her village. She loved to travel. Family and friends, especially at Hilton Head. knows Linda as his beloved daughter, whom he loves eternally, whom he formally adopted on the day that she was baptized. And Jesus made a promise to her on the day of her baptism that we heard about in this morning's gospel. It's a gospel I never get tired of reading, because every time I do, it bolsters my hope. It banishes fear. Jesus said, "I'm going to prepare a place for you. I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be." And Jesus kept that promise to Linda last Tuesday, September the 7th. And her obituary begins, "Linda May Moore, Evelyn, 68 years of age, passed away on Tuesday, September the 7th, 2021, at the Woodside of French Creek, following a lengthy battle with cancer." In so many of Jesus' appearances to his apostles and disciples after he rose from the dead, there were three things he consistently said. "Peace be with you. Do not be afraid. It is I." And those are words that we need to hear and that we welcome, because there are so many fears in our life. I think it's one of the reasons that the opening hymn today, "Be Not Afraid," we sing so often, because no matter what our age, no matter what our profession, we all have fears. Some of them we handle. Some of them we conceal very well. But so many of them we deal with every day. Fears that are common to our humanity, those everyday ones. Fear of losing our jobs, our health, our life savings, of another war, of an endless pandemic, or so it seems. Fear of an accident, misfortune, of being rejected, or feeling unwanted, of growing old and dependent, left alone. Those are fears of our humanity. And then there's the fear of loss. Loss of our hearing, our sight, our mobility, our memory, our control. Loss of loved ones. In this reality that we face today, called death. And to all of our fears, Jesus says to us, "Peace be with you. Do not be afraid. It is I." He's with us right now and always. And he is the one, really the only one, that can lift our confidence face of our fears. There was a great philosopher and theologian who, towards the end of his life, was asked what was the most important truth that he had discovered in his vast learning, studying, and teaching. And he said, quoting that old hymn that you and I know so very well, saying it's all there, "Jesus loves me, this I know." Those of you who are parents, you think back when your kids were very small. Put them to bed, hoping that they would go to sleep. Even those little night lights to give them some reassurance that they woke up didn't always work. And there'd be that nightmare. And the child calls out, "Mommy, Daddy, Mommy, Daddy." And you know the only remedy was to go to them. Not just to call from the next room, but to go and reassure them. Comfort them. Talk them back into bed. And those age-old words that parents and grandparents say all the time, we all know what they are. Mama, it's all right. It's all right. It's the same with us. Face to face with this great anxiety of all death. And our emotions, they won't be bright right now. They run the gamut. But we still have someone who hears us and reassures us. It's all right now. It's all right. And that someone is the Lord Himself, who is present to us in His holy word, the scriptures, in His sacraments, in His church. And we hear Jesus say to us, "Peace be with you. Do not be afraid. It is I." Amen. We come together today, and I hope we are reassured by His presence. We believe that God, in His own way, makes all things right. And so for Linda, and so for all of us, it's all right now. It's all right. I'll leave you with a story that for any of us who have lost someone, and I lost both my mother and father that way. But it's a story that gives me some consolation. And it's a story that I think has us look at that question that we all know in common. Here's how the story goes. There was a woman in hospice care with cancer. Knew she was going to die, preparing for it. And there was a doctor friend of hers, a solid Christian man. She invited him to come and visit her at her home, not as a doctor, but as a Christian man that she knew would give her a straight answer. And he came. Went upstairs to her bedroom. It was just the two of them. And she asked that question, "What's it going to be like on the other side?" Something we all wonder. And it was close for her. "What's it going to be like on the other side?" And this doctor friend thought for a moment, trying to decide what he would like to say, what the Lord would direct him to say. Wasn't quite sure, but all of a sudden, the closed door of the bedroom on the other side, there was this scratching sound, and he had an idea. And he said to the woman, "Hear that scratching on the other side of the bedroom door? That's my daughter. I told her to stay downstairs at the foot of the landing. When I came back down, we continue our walk. But do you think she listened?" She came up these stairs. "Now, my dog has never been in your house before. My dog has no idea what's on the other side of this door. But my dog does know one thing. angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come and welcome you and take you home to the heavenly Jerusalem. May you have eternal rest, happiness, and peace, and may all of us, as your family and as your friends, take comfort in believing this. Amen. Let's stand and place our petition. After each prayer, we can answer, Lord, hear our prayer. For Linda, when baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Linda was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet, we pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Linda. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray for the Lord. Friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray for the Lord. The family and friends of Linda seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain. Dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray for the Lord. Heavenly Father, source of all blessing, we thank you for the gift of Linda's life. And today, with tears but hearts full of gratitude, we return that gift to you, knowing and believing that we will see each other again. Send your blessing upon her family and upon her friends. Receive all the prayers we place before you in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Lord be with you.
Amen.
so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Similar way that supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, to drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember your servant Linda, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with her son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
I say there's a man performed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the joyful hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace the Lord be with you always. Offer each other a sign of peace. throne table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever.